So I'm going to make potato leek soup. It's a new attempt to. I've only made it once. It's a long time ago. But this one's a different recipe. So, okay. First, so don't mind the mess in the kitchen. So first, you got to cut up bacon. Romero, what you doing, big guy? Okay, then I'm going to cook the bacon. Okay, so highlight. Bacon's cooking. Potatoes are chopped. I'm chopping some onions. I'm going to grate some carrots. I'm going to cut up some leek and rinse it so it gets all the sand out. And, yeah, so just doing some prep work. Alright, so the bacon's cooked. Now I'm just going to drain off the fat and add the vegetables and chicken. Okay, so with the leeks, the best trick to do is fill up a bowl of water, cold water, and then cut up your leeks, and then add the leeks to it, and just kind of separating them as you kind of swish them around and stuff, because they're very sandy, and and just let them sit for a little bit, and then all the sand will collect at the bottom, and then you don't have to, that's how you clean them. That's the easiest way to do it. So, okay, so I have the bacon, I have the potatoes, I have some grated carrot, and I have chopped up onion, and I'm going to add some chicken stock before it starts to burn. So I just want to cover it, kind of thing. I'm going to add the leek. No casualties. There we go. Okay. Just give it a stir. Okay, and let that cook for, like, I don't know, 10-15 minutes or so. Cover it until it's cooked. And then we'll come back. It doesn't fit. I don't have a lid for it, so that'll do. So it's still cooking. I took the lid off because probably put too much chicken stock in it, and I just want to let some of the chicken stock evaporate while it's cooking, so that way there I can add more milk, because you're supposed to add milk to it. So yeah, anyways, still cooking. The downfall of having a lid that's too big for your pot is the liquid tends to drip down and make a mess. So, oh well, I'll have to clean that later. Anyways, it smells really good. The recipe calls in, like, after, let's see, I was supposed to add a celery seed already. I'm going to add some spices. Parsley. Celery seed. Pepper. Almost forgot to add it, but that's fine. Still cooking for a little bit. So anyways, it's almost done. And we'll let it cook down a little bit more. Okay, so to the milk mixture, I'm going to add some flour. And I'm going to whisk until smooth. Then I'm going to add it to that.
Make smooth there.
Bring it to a boil, and then I'm going to cook it on the boil for a couple of minutes, and then it should be done. But anyways, it looks really good so far. So yeah, I'm going to boil it for a couple minutes, and yeah. So the recipe that I have technically calls for me to add Velveeta at the end. But I don't have any, and I'm all out of cheese, so I can't add cheese. But I think it'll still be really good just the way it is. It smells like just so much flavor in there. And, oh, it's going to be awesome. So, yeah. Also, while it's boiling for that extra couple minutes, make sure you keep stirring it every once in a while. So you don't want it to stick. It's warm in here. It's summer and I'm cooking. I'm sweating. I'd say that's done. I'm just going to take that off the heat and I'm going to give her a little taste. And I'm going to let you know what I think. I think it's going to be good. But let's see. It's really hot. Ooh, I don't want to burn myself. Ooh, hot. That's really good. It's very creamy. Very, very creamy. I think it would be really good with a little cheese in it. But like I said, I don't have any. So you just make do with what you got. That's really good. There's a lot of flavor. I can really taste that bacon. So yeah. Try that out. I can't believe how creamy that got.